All right, I want to thank you for being with us today. Today's Monday, December the 11th. Yesterday on the 10th, we had a great time in the Lord. Had about 10 folks get saved in the morning service, and about that same amount got baptized on Sunday night. Had dinner on the grounds, which is always a good time. But the main thing is the preaching of the gospel and seeing souls come to Christ. The old time way, the old time religion, never going to die. And I'm thankful for the effectiveness of the ministry when you do things the way that God tells you to do it in His book. So we're so thankful for the Word of God. We're so thankful for the gospel. Now, a couple years ago, Pastor Ryman and myself started putting out some encouragement to memorize some scripture, and we've been trying to do that along. And we don't talk about it maybe as much as we should, but every once in a while we try to remind you and encourage you to memorize the scripture. So this week, instead of having a Bible teaching here on the channel, we're going to have some scripture quotation, and we'll encourage you and try to inspire you to memorize the scripture for yourself. You don't have to be very smart. You don't have to be very intelligent or have some great mind in order to hide God's word in your heart. Just a little bit of discipline and stay at it a little bit every day, and you can get some scriptures memorized. So if you got a favorite passage, or if you got a passage that speaks to you every time that you go through the scripture, then go ahead and try to memorize it, and it certainly will be a help and a blessing to you. It'll help you mentally, it'll help you spiritually. And there's just nothing that bad that can be said about memorizing the scripture. Like I say, sometimes I'm not very educated, and sometimes I have a hard time putting into words what's going on inside my head. Sometimes I'll be speaking and just my mind will freeze up, and I'll have to sit there and think a little while about what I'm trying to say. I'm in myself started putting out But that makes no difference at all. God gets glory out of hiding His word in your heart and loving His word. God gets glory out of that. So many people don't love it. So many people want nothing to do with it. And though I would be very willing to admit that I was a sinner. I'm a sinner saved by grace, but I'm a sinner and very imperfect man. I certainly do love God's word. I know what it's done for me. As bad as I am, I know I'd be much worse without the scripture and without God's spirit. And so let me encourage you. Memorize the scripture. Spend lots of time in the word of God, and it will pay off for you. Be great benefits for your life. So today we're going to try to quote Matthew chapter number 1. There are a couple of places where I actually, in the course of memorizing it, I memorized it wrong, memorized the wrong word. So oftentimes I'll misquote it. I quote it to my wife, and she checks me out in the Bible, and I've misquoted it a couple of times already. So I've tried to work those things out and spend a little extra time on it. And so we'll give it a shot here. And again, get in the Word of God, read it, pray over it, and then memorize it, and it'll do you great good. Now pray for us, pray for me, pray for this channel, pray for our church, and we'll appreciate it. I thank you very much for watching. We don't have a ton of people watching the channel, but those that do, we appreciate you. And so without further delay, let's get into Matthew chapter 1. Matthew chapter 1, it's the Christmas season here in December, so I thought this would be a very appropriate passage to memorize. All right, Matthew chapter number 1, the book of the generation of Jesus Christ, the son of David, the son of Abraham. Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac begat Jacob, and Jacob begat Judas and his brethren. And Judas begat Phares and Zerah of Tamar, and Phares begat Esrom, and Esrom begat Aram, and Aram begat Amminadab, and Amminadab begat Naasson, and Naasson begat Salmon, and Salmon begat Boaz of Rahab, and Boaz begat Obed of Ruth, and Obed begat Jesse, and Jesse begat David the king, and David the king begat Solomon of her that had been the wife of Urias. And Solomon begat Rehoboam, and Rehoboam begat Abiah, and Abiah begat Asa, and Asa begat Josaphat, and Josaphat begat Joram, and Joram begat Ozias. And Ozias begat Jotham, and Jotham begat Achaz, and Achaz begat Ezekias. And Ezekias begat Manasseh, and Manasseh begat Amon, and Amon begat Josias, and Josias begat Jeconias and his brethren about the time they were carried away to Babylon. And after they were brought to Babylon, Jeconias begat Salathiel, and Salathiel begat Zorobabel, and Zorobabel begat Abiud, and Abiud begat Eliakim, and Eliakim begat Azor, and Azor begat Sadoc, and Sadoc begat Achim, and Achim begat Eliud, and Eliud begat Eleazar, and Eleazar begat Mathan, and Mathan begat Jacob, and Jacob begat Joseph, the husband of Mary, of whom was born Jesus, who is called Christ. So all the generations from Abraham to David are 14 generations, and from David until the carrying away into Babylon are 14 generations, and from the carrying away into Babylon unto Christ are 14 generations. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now, all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.